the race is on to find a submersible that vanished while diving on the Titanic shipwreck. Five people were on board. The U.S. and Canadian Coast Guards have launched an all-out search with planes and ships and buoys equipped with sonar. The ocean at that point is about 13,000 feet deep in that area. And as of yesterday afternoon, officials estimated the passengers might have had somewhere between 70 and 96 hours worth of air left if the sub is still intact. Now, this was a sightseeing expedition that costs $250,000 a person. The passengers included a British billionaire explorer, a Pakistani businessman, and his son. There are also reports by the CBC and CTV News in Canada that a famous French diver and Titanic expert was also on the sub. These are some of the last images of the submersible as it began its descent on Sunday morning. The deepest ever underwater rescue was less than 2,000 feet. So this could be an unprecedented rescue if the Coast Guard finds that sub. CNN national correspondent Jason Carroll has the latest on the search from Boston. And I think that context, that comparison, the deepest ever was 2,000. This could be as much as 13,000. What have you learned overnight?
Yeah.
Well, you can tell that search and rescue crews are dealing with a number of challenges. The Boston Coast Guard basically says that they're searching in an area that's extremely remote. They've reached out to experts in the field of deep sea exploration, and they also realize at this point, time is simply just not on their side.
We're doing everything that we can do to locate the submersible and rescue those on board.
Search and rescue teams from the United States and Canada are working around the clock in the North Atlantic to locate a lost submersible with five people on board. Search planes have been scanning the ocean's surface, sonar buoys deployed to try to detect any sound from the missing vessel.
The location of the search is approximately 900 miles east of Cape Cod in a water depth of roughly 13,000 feet.
According to the Coast Guard, the submersible lost communication with its mothership, the Polar Prince, less than 2 hours into its descent Sunday morning as it ventured towards the wreckage of the Titanic. The company that operates the submersible on voyages to the Titanic, OceanGate Expeditions, releasing this statement, "Our entire focus is on the well-being of the crew, and every step possible is being taken to bring the five crew members back safely." On board, businessman Hamish Harding, who is no stranger to adventure.
I've always wanted to do this.
Recently, he was a passenger on Blue Origin's June 2022 spaceflight. On Saturday, he posted on his Facebook page, "I am proud to finally announce that I joined OceanGate Expeditions for their RMS Titanic mission as a mission specialist on the sub going down to the Titanic." Also on board, Pakistani businessman Shahzada Dawood and his son Suleiman Dawood. Their family issuing a statement saying, "We are very grateful for the concern being shown by our colleagues and friends and would like to request everyone to pray for their safety." According to OceanGate Expeditions website, the 21-foot, 23,000-pound submersible made of carbon fiber and titanium has up to 96 hours, 4 days, of oxygen for five people. Larry Daly, a Titanic expert, has been inside the 21-foot vessel.
I was in the sub for 12 hours. We have our own breathing system on board, and if that's maintained properly, like changing your filter and your CO2 scrubber, you can stay down there for, you know, quite a few hours.
In an interview with CBS last year, OceanGate Expedition CEO touting the submersible's safety.
Everything else can fail. Your thrusters can go, your lights can go, you're still going to be safe.
And also, according to OceanGate, there is some sort of an early warning detection system on board that's supposed to alert the pilot in case something goes wrong. Also on board, a system in place that's supposed to help the vessel resurface again if something goes wrong. But again, at this point, it's just unclear, Victor and Poppy, what exactly went wrong with this vessel. Back to you.
Jason Carroll reporting for us. Thank you, Jason.
For more on this, let's bring in deep sea explorer and oceanographer David Gallo. He is the senior advisor for strategic initiatives at RMS Titanic, Inc. David, thank you so much for being with us. Look, you've done this type of work for the better part of four decades. How likely is it that they will find this submersible in time before the oxygen runs out?
Well, certainly, hi, Poppy. Time is against us at this point. And the only thing that we can say is that everything that can be done is being done. And that includes the Coast Guard at the surface, listening a bit beneath the surface, and then assembling right now are some of the best robotic people with robots and ships to respond right away if they do find that submarine.
David, we have the pictures of the submarine in this pretty blue water. I mean, it is beautiful. But when we're talking 13,000 feet down, give our viewers the reality of what it actually looks like down there.
It's a whole different world, Victor. Normally a dive, you begin on the surface in a light blue, pretty color blue that we're familiar with. It takes 2.5 hours to get to the bottom, roughly. And you start to drift down slowly through that water column. You leave the blue behind. It gets medium blue, deep blue, dark blue, and then black for about 2 hours. And this is a place where it's been eternally cold and pressure's building. So when you land, you're landing, as I said, almost on it's a very unfamiliar world where all sorts of different kinds of creatures live and there's different kinds of landscapes.
I was really struck, David, by this part of the CBS Sunday Morning Report just from last year by the journalist David Pogue. I want you to listen to one part of this.
There's no GPS underwater, so the surface ship is supposed to guide the sub to the shipwreck by sending text messages.
Turn 30 degrees right?
Probably, yeah, 30 degrees.
But on this dive, communications somehow broke down. The sub never found the wreck.
We were lost. We were lost for 2.5 hours.
Rush says he'll offer those passengers a free do-over next year.
If they got lost and there's no GPS, how do you find this now?
Well, the thing about that is, I mean, that does happen. It's unfortunate that it happened with David Pogue. And there's been no communication with the sub. So even if you're lost, there's usually communications back and forth with the sub. You just don't know exactly where you are, and you hope the surface can tell you. It's just in a way the looking actively, listening a bit, but looking actively with sonars, a bit with cameras to see if they can locate the sub. And they'll probably begin with the last known position of where the sub was last heard.
Yeah. Let's put up the graphic again showing just how deep the water is at the wreck site of the Titanic. And in comparison, you see some of the iconic buildings across the country. You see the height of, I believe that's the Empire State Building. David, my question to you, Grand Canyon as well. We first met you, our first conversation was during MH370 when that disappeared. And I was surprised by how little we know about how much of the ocean, because the Titanic wreck is there. Are we familiar with this part of the North Atlantic, that we know the depths, we know what is there?
We know it probably better than most places because we've been there. But we're still learning things about it, about the currents that sweep through there, like underwater, almost like a wind that blows beneath the water, except it's water, from different quadrants, and from the north, from the east. We're learning about that. And learning about the animals that live in that spot. So, yeah, we know it better, but there's no guarantees, and there are always surprises.
You're a deep-sea explorer, so you have a unique perspective and vantage to all of this that many of us don't. Can you speak to the mental toll of being inside that very small space with those people who obviously know now that something went terribly wrong?
Poppy, I can't imagine, and the entire community. You know, P.H. Nargile, a colleague of mine, my closest colleague, and one of the best at this, searching, is on board that expedition. So it's something we always think about as explorers and scientists that go to the deep.
Yeah.
And we've always known something like this could happen, and now it's happened, but we're still pretty much in shock, the community is.
Yeah.
I hope it has a good ending.
Of course, we all do. David Gallo, thank you very much.
Thank you.